So what I have here, you can see, is a region, and I want you to think of this as being like a city, let's say, and some region, and these dots are going to appear. And let's think of them as being some events, like in particular, let's think of them as being serious crimes that occur in the city. And as I run this, there's a second crime, there's a third crime, and a fourth crime. And I'll mute myself for a second and say, you can start to say, well, what sort of patterns can we learn? And as the crimes come in, we might say, what can we learn about the city? And I've only gone four so far, I'm going to do more, but let's say right away, we say, well, these all look like they took place right at the bottom, right at the southern part. So if you had to decide based on that, you might say, you know, I think the southern part of the city, that's the really dangerous part. But let's continue, and let's put in more. That one was going north, and let's put in more. Okay, let's say we do that many. And now we say, well, what do we think? Well, it sure looks like the southern part is quite dangerous in this case. There's all these crimes along the southern part, only a few in the north. So you might start to draw conclusions, right? You might start to say, oh, yeah, you know, I think really the southern part of the city is really dangerous. Let me put in some more. Maybe not many more. Okay. And as you get to see more, you probably find certain patterns. Now, let's see what we have here. So in this case, well, there's sort of clusters. Like, for example, here's a whole bunch right together. You might think there's some really dangerous apartment complex around there, right, where dangerous things are happening. This part here looks a little bit dangerous. There's so much spread out. Let me put in a few more, and then I'll get to the point here. Okay, so if we put in four, we can see now that I think it's fair to say that this looks like the most dangerous part of the city. Lots of crime being committed here. Fairly safe otherwise, although actually reasonably spread out in this case. But the point of this, why do I run this little simulation, is that I wrote this little program myself, and what I made sure to happen here is that, in fact, every dot is completely independent of all the other dots and completely equally likely to be anywhere on the surface. So I actually get completely uniform. And I must admit, this one looks a little more uniform than it sometimes does. I'll tell you what, let me do it one more time, because the point is, it's actually happening completely uniformly. But if you start to look at it, you'll tend to find patterns. So in this case, it looks like the southwest is completely safe, and this looks like a really safe part, but then around here looks really dangerous. And when you start to see clumps, you start to see that might be a really dangerous thing. But the point is, because I wrote the program, I know that there's actually no patterns here at all, no true patterns. There's no causal. The next dot is equally likely to be anywhere on the surface. Now, what's the point of it? Well, it's just some dots on the screen. But the point is that, as humans, we're very quick to look for patterns and to see patterns. And to some extent, this helps us a lot because we need to understand the world through patterns. But we can also see patterns even when there aren't any real patterns there. And in particular, we can see patterns when there's things that are really independent or really just random, just because by probabilities that will tend to happen. And one way to talk about it is what's called Poisson clumping. So some of you may know this phrase, which says that if things are just happening independently, uniformly, then they will satisfy certain probabilities, which are called Poisson probabilities. And those probabilities will tend to mean that certain regions in this case will tend to have a very large number of events, and certain regions will tend to have a very small number, just by chance alone. So it doesn't mean you can never draw conclusions by looking at the way things develop. But it means not just crimes, but, you know, if you see three different people with purple hair on the same day, it could mean there's a new